So with that, Andy, I'd ask you to advance to our first slide. I am thrilled to be here with you all this evening as we celebrate the remarkable talents of our student artists. My name is Benjamin Hoffman, and I'm honored to serve as the president of the Pennsylvania Art Education Association. Alongside me this evening are several esteemed board members and our executive council applauding the outstanding achievements showcased in this year's exhibition. First and foremost, I'd like to extend my gratitude to Andy Keefe for orchestrating the Youth Art Month exhibition and Becky Hughes for organizing this year's flag contest. I also want to express gratitude to David Dietz, the Fine Arts Consultant at the Pennsylvania Department of Education, for his unwavering support and commitment to the visual arts. And just a brief overview of this evening, just a few more remarks about the program, our association, and then we'll dive into the awards, acknowledgments, and the closing. The Pennsylvania Art Education Association serves as the premier state association for art educators across the Commonwealth, advocating for and fostering visual arts education through professional development, leadership, and service. With a membership exceeding 800 art educators from both public and private schools, we collaborate closely with stakeholders, arts leaders, and educational institutions statewide to offer enriching, research-driven experiences for our members and their students. As here, we see Youth Art Month was initiated in 1961 and celebrates the transformative power of arts education, and it enhances our quality of life. Now celebrated by the Council for Arts Education, this month-long celebration advocates for robust school art programs and promotes art material safety. And our exhibition here demonstrates the impact of art education, nurturing skills like problem-solving, creativity, observation, and communication. In alignment with the National Art Education Association, we recognize the pivotal role of visual arts education in fostering empathy, promoting social justice, and instigating positive societal change. And art serves as a conduit for understanding diverse perspectives and inspiring critical thinking, a necessity especially relevant in today's world. Andy, we'll go ahead to the next slide. So I want to extend my heartfelt appreciation to our regional representatives, our board members, and sponsors for their unwavering support of this exhibition. A special thanks in a moment we'll share again to the Blick Art Materials for their generous contributions towards this year's awards, to Fresh Artists for adorning the state capitol building with banners, and I'll let our Youth Art Month chair speak to that in a moment. But before we do that and introduce all the folks here with us this evening, I want to send a special thank you to the parents and guardians, thanking for standing beside our students, nurturing their creative spirits, and supporting their artistic endeavors. And to our students, you are the heart of this celebration. That's why we are here tonight. Your resilience, your dedication, your boundless creativity inspires every one of us. Today, we applaud your achievements and envision the bright futures you will shape through your art. And before we proceed any further, if you did not already know, we have over 300 student artworks featured in this virtual exhibition. And I'd like to ask at this moment for everyone, if you would join me in unmuting or throwing an emoji, join me in showcasing our students with a resounding round of applause. I love that. So if, again, just kindly ask that we mute so each of us can hear the lovely, you know, acknowledgments of our student artists tonight. But again, I want to congratulate our artists, thanking you for being a part of this inspiring journey. And let us continue to champion the transformative power of art together. And at this time, Andy, I'm going to transition. You're welcome to our next slide. I invite Andy and Becky to come forward and present this year's award winners.
So, hi, I'm Andy. And Becky and I are the Youth Art Month co-chairs. We're also art educators in the School District of Philadelphia. Becky, do you want to say hi?
Yep, I waved. Hello. I'm a K through 5 elementary art teacher in the School District of Philadelphia.
And I know Becky was inviting all the artists to put their name in the chat. If you haven't already done so, please do that. It's great to know you're here. So if you go online to that URL, you will see the entire Youth Art Month exhibit. As Ben said, there are over 300 student artworks, and all 12 regions throughout Pennsylvania are represented. If you have another device like a phone and you want to use your camera to use the QR code, that will also launch it as well. And we're going to go through the entire exhibit later, but for now, we're going to jump ahead and introduce our jurors this year. We had Eric Anthony Burtis, Melissa Madani-Hames and Tim McFarlane. And I am very thankful to these folks because they had the really difficult job of, going through such a quantity and quality group of student artwork. And no doubt it was a difficult task to make the selections for the awarded works. So the works, after they made their selections, thank you to Fresh Artists, we had the awarded works printed on these large banners, and then we brought them to the state capitol, and they are presently hanging in the East Wing Rotunda of the state capitol, and they will be on display through the month of March. If you're able to get to Harrisburg to see them, I encourage you to go check that out. But if you can't, we included a few photos. So you can see this display here in the Capitol. They look amazing. It was really nice, even as we were hanging them up, seeing folks stopping to look at them and admire the work. So without further ado, we do want to recognize each of the awardees. We'll go through. We're going to start, Becky, if you can start us off with the division awards.
Sure. So, we went right to it. Congratulations. Congratulations, Carmela Moore. She's our elementary school division winner.
She's a fifth grade student from Salzburg Elementary.
Sorry, were we going to do that part too? Sorry, Carmela. Fifth grade Salzburg Elementary School. Our middle school division winner was McKenna Lausch, eighth grader at Western School. The title of this piece is Bookworm. Absolutely fabulous. And our high school division winner, Liam Seitz, 12th grade Lower Dolphin High School. Title, Does It Really Not Matter?
And moving on to the media awards. So for the digital media award, this goes to Michelle Tanzel. And Michelle is a 12th grade student from Horace Howard Furness. The title is Ryuka and Usagi. Sorry if I mistake the pronunciation. The Mixed Media Award goes to Jennifer Lee, who is a 12th grade student at Central High School. And the Painting Drawing Media Award goes to Anya Adame, who is a 12th grade student at Central Bucks High School East. And this work is titled Digitally Blind. We have the Photography Medium Award that goes to Reynold Cowdery. Reynold is a 12th grade student at Abington High School. The Printmaking Media Award goes to Olivia Stepnowska. Olivia is an 11th grade student at Central High School, and the work is titled Peaking Sun. The Sculpture Media Award goes to Zoe Buchanan. Zoe is a 12th grade student from Warwick High School, and this is titled Bok Bok Bok. I can't not laugh when I say that too.
Sorry, not. It's great.
And then the Fibers Media Award goes to Jillian Curry. Jillian's a 10th grade student from Emmaus High School, and this work is titled John Flansburg. All right, Region Awards, Becky.
All right. Our regions, we have 12 of them in the state of Pennsylvania. And so we have one art winner from each region. Region one winner is Gianna Giles, 12th grade at West Allegheny High School. Mind over matter. Region two winner, Enzo Richardson. Enzo, I think I saw you on here. Congratulations. Third grade, Erie Day School. Region 3 winner, Kendall Doty, 10th grade, Franklin Area Junior Senior High School, title Desert Flora. Very nice. Region 4 winner, Boer Nee, 2nd grade, Ferguson Township Elementary School. The Region 5 winner is Braden Dowds, 12th grade, Mercer High School, the title My Heart May Burst. Region 6 winner, Abraham Manfred, 11th grade at Hollidaysburg Area Senior High School, title Gift of the Giver. Region 7 winner, Peyton Throne, 10th grade, Northeastern High School, title is Train Case. Region 8 winner, Oakley White, kindergarten. Hello, Oakley, I saw you sign in too. Kindergarten at Sullivan County Elementary School. The title is Oakley Kitty 2023. Our Region 9 winner is Genesis Fernandez, 12th grade at West Scranton High School. Title, Niagara Falls. Our Region 10 winner is Kaylin Davis, 12th grader at Catasqua. Oh, that one really trips me up, CJ. What is it? Catasauqua High School. The title is Excision. I hope I said that right. Region 11 winner, Sarah Barrett's 12th grade, Villa Joseph Marie High School. And last but not least, our Region 12 winner, Emily McGoldrick, 12th grade, Garnet Valley High School.
As far as the overall winners, we have an honorable mention that goes to Jose Galeno Gomez. Jose is an 11th grade student from Norristown Area High School. And our Best in Show winner goes to Holly Ann Carzola. And Holly Ann is a 12th grade student from Warwick High School. And this is titled Marin. So can we just take a moment to congratulate all those winners, so many. And thank you to our to our judges too for that. All right. And then Becky, you're going to take over for the talk about the flag design.
Yes. So we had a great result with entries with flags this year. It was very, very exciting. Our jurors are here on this page. Jenna Wilchinski, Gloria Haig, and Iva Kelman are three artists and friends of mine that went through all the different entries and made their best, did their best to kind of choose what represented Pennsylvania as well as it could and was as good with the artistic work as well. So thank you, Iva, Gloria, and Jenna. Like, who did I say already? A little bit about the YAM Flag Design Contest. In order to promote Youth Art Month, the Council for Art Education, known as CFAE, coordinates activities on a national level. So these flags, we do the statewide call for flags for entries. We judge them, and then we choose one flag as an overall winner that will get made into an actual flag and sent to the national conference, the NAEA conference, which PAEA, Pennsylvania Art Education Association, is part of. All the flags get hung together at this national conference, and it's just a really cool and fun way to advocate for the arts and advocate for your state. So all of you that participated in that may be here, thank you. The advocacy and overall winner, this is the one that was made into a flag, is Juliana Vasquez, 11th grade, Catasauqua High School. Excellent job. Our elementary school division winner is Liana Weishaupt, kindergarten at Nebinger Elementary School. Our middle school division winner is Thomas Zhang, 7th grader at Castor Gardens Middle School. And our high school division winner is Kaylin Rivera, 11th grader at Catasauqua High School.
So all the flag design contest winners and the YAM exhibit award winners, they're going to have a certificate of excellence as well as a prize mailed to their teachers. And then the teachers can distribute it to the students at school. We want to thank Blick Art Materials for providing all the prizes, which will be these gift cards that we're distributing. So thank you, teachers, for making sure you pass those out. I will be sending them out in the next couple of weeks. And then this is to you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. And I think before I go on to thank any other folks, I just want to extend a great big appreciation and congratulations to all of our student artists. What an incredible display of artwork. And for the 300 plus student artworks, just well done and well achieved. We did want to do a few special acknowledgments because we could not make this possible without not only the board of directors, the Pennsylvania Department of Education, Dr. Khalid Mumin, who is our Secretary of Education, as mentioned before, Owen David Dietz, who is the Fine Arts Consultant for the Department of Education, the Council for Art Education, our national partner, the National Art Education Association, our jurors, Fresh Artists, and Blick Art Materials. And if it wasn't mentioned, that flag that's going to be proudly displayed will be traveling all the way to Minneapolis in just a few weeks. So stay tuned. I'll be sure to share some photos. I'm very excited. Please advance to the next slide.
Oh, my goodness.
Few other just acknowledgments. Again, I think it's just important to recognize that there are people doing the important work to celebrate the arts. And not only is this a celebration, but it's an ask and call to action, because we could not continue to do this work without your support and the support of legislators and folks in policy to help move these decisions forward. So just to bring attention to some of the work that our association does, most recently, the month of March 2023 was Music in Our Schools Month, Theater in Our Schools, Dance in Our Schools, and Youth Art Month in Pennsylvania. And this particular bill was moved forward for this year to advocate to ensure that this isn't longstanding and in perpetuity, that we will always see Youth Art Month and dance, schools, music, and theater being represented. And while it's a celebration of just 1 month, we know that the arts transcend 365 days a year and for a lifetime. So we just want to give a thanks to all those who have helped and the people that we've worked with. The next slide is the people who we don't often celebrate enough, but to thank all of our participating art teachers. There were 64 art teachers this year. And I ask that you send them the biggest thanks. If they are not here tonight, thank them tomorrow. I don't even know if I mentioned I'm a high school art teacher. I was coming right from school to be here. Like, this is our blood passion. Like, we love everything we do. We want to pour our hearts into you guys. So we thank you enough. Can't thank you enough. So we're trying something new this year, this next slide. So bear with us. We wanted to give a little bit of a thank you. So Andy, I'll let you take back here for a moment.
Okay. So we're going to spin this, and one of the numbers is associated with one of those teachers on the list. So wish us luck here as a little trial. Ready? See where we land. All right. What's the number? We got 19. Let's check our list. 19.
All right. 19.
Oh, we got Aaron Welsh. Aaron.
Congratulations, hey, Aaron.
Yay, Aaron.
Oh, my
All right,
goodness.
Back to you, Ben. I'll write that awesome. Down.
Congratulations.
Aaron, her gift card.
That's fantastic. A few other things we just want to share with you tonight, things that perhaps you didn't know that the association does for our students, for our educators, and for our communities. We've been very fortunate to recognize school communities for the outstanding work that they're doing. And this is an endorsement that if your teacher is not here tonight, let them know. And since you've been a part of this exhibition, they have seen emails. We represent schools with an endorsement labeled the Outstanding Visual Arts Community. We've celebrated now 5 years. It's a great opportunity to represent your school, represent your community, and what a great way to just celebrate the arts beyond what happens in the classroom, because we know the arts just transcend our lives in every way. So it's programs that are rigorous and inclusive, programs that are highly accessible and highly visible. So to learn more, we just wanted to share that this evening. It's available on our website, but a QR code will take you there as well. Next slide. What makes not only this celebration so fun is that this fall is Pennsylvania Art Education Association's 75th anniversary. That is a tremendous milestone. And for folks who do not know, we supersede the National Art Education Association in terms of the 9 times of in Pennsylvania.
All right, so finish your serves and catch.
We have so much to share, and we are excited that some of this work will find its way there again to be seen by all of the art teachers. We bring together that cohort. Like we said, we have nearly 800 plus art educators in the Commonwealth. So we're going to be celebrating that legacy. We're going to be celebrating the work of our students and what happens in and out of our classrooms. So we're now opening that call for proposals. So we are just ongoing. It's amazing what our organization has done. And then lastly, I want to say thank you. On behalf of the Pennsylvania Art Education Association, I extend my gratitude to each of you. As we conclude this event, I encourage you to carry the spirit of celebration with you throughout the entire year. And a super large congratulations to you all. And just some kind of housekeeping. For more information, you can certainly visit our website at paea.org. There's a lot of opportunities for students to be recognized beyond just the Youth Art Month exhibition. There you can also see the entire exhibition and stay up to date on all the developments of future programmings and events in art education. So at this time, we invite everyone to join us as we play through each student artwork and showcase their talents. And while it is not required to stay, we want to appreciate your continued presence and ask that for one more time, let's give a huge round of applause for all of our artists, all of our arts educators, all of our outstanding arts communities. Feel free to unmute. Let's share some praise. And thank you again for your support and participation, everyone. Yes. So as I shared, we're going to play through all 300 artworks so that every student gets to see their work this evening. So please, if you feel like this is the space for you to hang out with us, grab yourself a snack, have a drink, enjoy this time while we listen to some music. We're going to run through them all. Enjoy this time, and I'm going to mute myself. And please, again, thank you for being here and have a great time. Thank you. All right. Well, I want to, that officially concludes our presentation this evening, and I want to thank everyone and all of our artists and all of our students, their families, their friends, their teachers for joining us this evening. What an incredible, incredible exhibition this was. Again, we ask that you continue to celebrate the arts year-round. We thank you again for your participation this evening, and we wish you all an enjoyable rest of your school year. Thank you again for joining, everyone, and have a lovely evening. Take care.